Make a video showing ZAXCOM users where to get their firmware. This has kind of changed over the years, as far as I'm aware, but here in 2023, the latest way to get your firmware is it's all hosted on a Google Drive run by ZAXCOM, and this is what we're looking at here. And you can see they have it broken into different categories: transmitters, receivers, different recorders. Before we go any deeper, I'll just show you how to even get here. I mean, the address is that, which is hard. So I'll actually just copy and paste this into the description of this video for a link to get you here. But another way to get there is if you go to ZAXCOM's user group on Facebook, which is, I believe, public and visible to anybody. So that means you don't have to be a Facebook user, I think, to even see this. But once you get to this main Facebook group, you can go to the featured section, and there it should be pinned here, this one right here. So if you click this link, it should bring you to that same page. Did it? Oh, it brought you to the post, and then you click it here, and now, yeah, we're back where we were. So this is how you get to the Google Drive that contains all this firmware, and I'm just going to kind of show you how I use it. If I was looking to see if there's any new Nova firmware, I would open this up and look in and see what they're up to. They do keep older versions here that are usually the known good ones. So you can go pretty far back if you wanted to. But I want to see the newest stuff here, and it looks like they have a couple betas out. So I'd open this and I'd download it here. It's pretty obvious stuff, I think, for most people. But just in case you're wondering how this works, did it download? It did not. Let me try it again. There it goes. I needed a double click. All right, so I'll close this and I will find this on my desktop. I'll open it, unzip it, look in the folder. And it's kind of unfortunate you can't see the release notes before you download it, because it would be cool if you could just look at release notes, from where it is on the Google Drive. But anyway, we're gonna first thing I usually do is look at the release notes, because this is where you find out what they changed in the latest version. So the newest is at the top. So since the last one, they have added a fixed FP7 version not being calculated properly when Nova is rebooted. I don't know what that means, but maybe that fixes your problem, because I see some people posting saying, oh, like, hey, my Nova does this weird thing, and it turns out, maybe it was fixed several firmwares ago. So it's a good way to kind of look back and just see if anything jumps out at you. It's not always just fixes either. Sometimes it's added features, like they've added some things over the 3 years since the Nova's been out. So there you go. So I would look here first to see if it fixes your problem or adds a feature that you wish you had. But do note that some of these are beta, which means install at your own risk and use them at your own risk on your show. And if they're not labeled beta, they should be safe. Probably like these ones here for Nova anyway. Another thing to point out here is that in many of these zipped up versions, they'll include like a how-to guide to install firmware. For example, here's a document on how to update the MRX firmware modules within the Nova. It gives you examples, but otherwise you're mostly you should be able to find how to install firmware for each device on its individual user manual. And I think the quickest way to find those is to go to zaxcom.com, not comma, and go to the product page, pick a product that you're trying to do, LE5, for example, go to support, and there's your manual. Click that, it will open up. And then somewhere in here, you'll probably find something about firmware. Go to that section, and here it is. These are the directions. So hopefully that was helpful for you guys. I know there's like a new wave of certainly ZAXCOM Nova users that I'm seeing cropping up, asking a lot of questions I see get asked a lot. So hopefully this is helpful, and yeah. See you next time.